We all know this object. Drones are now part of the consumer electronics, and in the future they will play an important role in logistics of goods and people. Inside a drone there are tens of sensors which are needed for a stable and safe operation. One of the most important sensors is the e-compass. Together with the GPS, the drone uses the e-compass during navigation to compute its spatial orientation by measuring the Earth magnetic field and gravity. The e-compass is made of two sensors, the accelerometer and the magnetometer. The first is based on the microelectromechanical technology, also called MEMS. The second uses the magnetoresistive technology. These two technologies require two separate fabrication processes, leading to higher integration cost. This is the reason that pushed us in developing our idea. If we could fabricate a magnetometer using MEMS technology, we could simplify the fabrication of the e-compass. The first advantage would be an economic one. The compasses are now present in every mobile device. Reducing the cost of each sensor by a few cents would be a great advantage for a company in the sensor business. A business which today is worth around 340 million euro and it's constantly growing. The second advantage is a performance one. Integrating two sensors in a single chip would improve performance such as sensors alignment and energy saving. Today, the alignment between the accelerometer and the magnetometer requires a post-assembly calibration. A calibration error could lead to a wrong reading of the magnetic field, with a consequent risk for the drone. Instead, two sensors fabricated on a single chip would be perfectly aligned. So here is the roadmap of our project. In 2019, we had the idea of integrating magnetic element with a silicon MEMS resonator using fabrication techniques of the semiconductor industry. This approach will allow us to reach high performance with a limited power consumption. Indeed, power consumption has been a limit for several MEMS devices proposed in the past. In 2020, we have developed the first prototypes and engineered the devices in order to maximize performance. The result of this engineering process led to the deposition of an Italian patent application in 2020 and an international patent application in 2021. We aim now to develop new prototypes in order to fully characterize this new technology. These new prototypes, together with the deposited patents, will help us in bringing this technology to an industrial partner through licensing.